So hi everyone, we are back with understanding consumer and producer surplus application now. There are several times where government imposes certain, government intervenes in the market, and by the virtue of intervention, it imposes certain price controls. And most often, owing to good politics, just to show up and in a good picture to the consumers, government imposes certain price ceilings. Price ceiling means there's a roof which indicates that this is the maximum price you can charge as a producer, and you just can't go above it. You may go below it, which none would want, but you can't go above it. So there's a price max, as you can see over here. The diagram is the same as before. This is my demand curve. This is my supply curve, which is the same as marginal cost curve. P naught is the price at which the market clears. Demand equals supply. And this is the artificial P max, the price ceiling, which the government has imposed in the market for certain good. It usually happens for some necessary items in times of crisis. For example, right now, the world is in a situation of crisis. So government has declared certain commodities as essential. So they have imposed price controls on some medicines, some of the masks, some of the food items which are necessities for the consumers. So that's a price max, like a price ceiling for the consumers. Now, as the word suggests, that the ceiling was imposed with the idea to protect consumer confidence. So consumer should benefit from the price max is what the idea was of the politician or the government who imposed it. Because ultimately, if there is a price ceiling above which the producers can't go, there is a set of consumers who might be thinking, who might have the ability to buy this particular good at a way higher price, and they would gain. So clearly, this particular mechanism is going to result in a net loss to producers more than the loss to consumers. We'll see how. Now, consider this price of P naught, the price at which the market equilibrates. And then this is the price of ceiling, that is P max. What is happening at this particular price now? At this particular price, the producers are willing to supply Q1. However, the consumers demand way too much, because why not? It's a lower price. I shall increase my demand. So consumers demand Q2. That means quantity demanded is greater than quantity in supply in the market. None is going to drop goods from the sky. So what will happen? There's a shortage of the goods. So a shortage arises in the market, which initially also hints that who is now going to gain and who is now going to lose. There's definitely a bunch of consumers who will lose because they no longer can get the goods which are now being in shortage. Let's see how. So Q naught was the quantity the consumers would have otherwise gotten at a price of P naught. But now, since the quantity has reduced from Q naught to Q1 and the price has been imposed at P max, these set of consumers, can you imagine that this demand curve is running till a price of P naught? This region was consumer surplus. So this particular shaded region, triangle B, means that these consumers can no longer get the goods. Since the goods are being rationed, the quantity has been reduced to Q1. So had the quantity been Q naught, had the price been P naught, things were so good. Things were rosy enough so that the B triangle, being lost by the lost consumer surplus to the consumers, would have been indeed a gain. But now they can no longer tap it, since the quantity sold in the market is just Q1. So B is definitely my first catch. That is the loss in consumer surplus because of the value lost that would have accrued to them if price was P naught and quantity was Q naught. But now they are rationed out from the market. They cannot buy the good anymore. And then there are other consumers also. up above this particular point, and these consumers have some insane power to buy the goods in the market because they have high ability. So they're willing to pay a quite higher price for the good, and the government is now indeed charging just a price Pmax. So these consumers are happy lot. They say, I would have otherwise also agreed to pay a price of P0, and now that you are going way too lower, that's a gain to me. So consumers over this particular range gain the amount in consumer surplus by the size of rectangle A. So why the size of rectangle A? Because the quantity at this is the quantity which is being sold, and this is the difference in price that they're gaining, P0 minus Pmax. So this is the entire area which is in addition to their consumer surplus, which would have otherwise also been gained at a price of P0. So I've written A is the increase in consumer surplus for consumers who can still buy the good as they can, that too at a lower price as they do at a price of Pmax. Hence, what is the net change in consumer surplus? The net change is a positive A and a negative B. As I've written, a positive A minus B. Since this rectangle has an area greater than this triangle, this particular difference will work out to be positive. That means net-net, these consumers do gain in the market. Now let's talk about the poor producers. What's happening to them? Now these particular producers also lost a lot. Indeed, they do not gain, but they lose a lot as a result of the price ceiling. Let's see how. So, with price controls, some producers, those with relatively lower costs, will choose to stay in the market, but they're now going to receive a lower price Pmax. You see, at a quantity of Q1, there is a set of producers over here who would have sold this good at a price of P0. But now they're being forced by the government to sell it at a price of Pmax. That means they are being made devoid of a producer surplus they would have otherwise gained. That means A is the region of loss in producer surplus for the producers who remain in the market and are forced to sell at a price lower than P0. And then there is a bunch of producers who cannot sell at all. Likewise, there was a set of consumers who can't buy at all, that was B. There is also a set of producers who can no longer sell in the market. So this triangle C indicates additional loss to the producer surplus for the producers who have to exit the market because quantity being produced and sold has reduced to Q1. And likewise, only those producers who had the ability to operate at lower costs are now operating in the market. Rest will have to exit. So clearly, producers lose on both the grounds. The net loss in producer surplus is minus A minus C. As written over here, hence net change in producer surplus is minus A minus C, that is negative. And clearly this shows that loss in producer surplus is greater than the loss in consumer surplus. And then there is a special terminology used to indicate these two triangles. The triangles which don't go to anyone. Since B is a triangle that indicates consumer surplus lost, C indicates producer surplus lost. That means there is a net change in the surplus having over here. That means if you add up both these surpluses, A minus B, plus minus A minus C, that would give you a minus B minus C. This is the total change in surplus in the market, and this indicates the loss being, loss accruing to both the sides of the market. So B plus C is the area which indicates a dead weight loss. So this is an inefficiency caused by the price controls. B would have accrued to certain consumers and C would have also accrued to some producers. But now, because the quantity has been reduced, price has been reduced, these two triangles no longer have a say in the market. So these consumers lost and these producers lost, and these losses go nowhere. Fine? So which is why we call this particular triangle as the deadweight lost. That is inefficiency caused by the price controls. Now there's one more thing which I wanted to tell you, but I would rather do it with another diagram. So we come on to a section like here. Consider this particular diagram in which the demand for the good is now highly inelastic. Inelastic means the demand curve is quite steeper. Rest everything is just the same. There's a price ceiling here also at P max. P naught is the market clearing price. But what is more astonishing is that the result indicates quite a large amount of loss in consumer surplus. And in fact, consumers were meant to lose here. Why so? Because we're talking about a good whose demand is inelastic. That means consumers value that particular good a lot. When you tend to value a good a lot, you have an inelastic demand towards it. A slight change in the price, you know, it doesn't affect you much, but you know, you are quite affected. You're quite affected if there are certain quantity controls and price controls over here. So there was a section of good who valued that particular good a lot. So these consumers had quite a good ability to pay for that good. And now that the good has been rationed out, the quantity has reduced, these particular consumers lose. So that means this loss in consumer surplus is way, way, way greater than the loss in producer surplus. All right. So this particularly indicates the examples. For example, they've given also of oil. So let's read out. During the three decades, 1960 to 1990 in India, LPG shortages resulted from oil and gas price controls. So government imposed controls on the prices of oil and gas, and that prevented domestic LPG prices from increasing and to rising world levels. So what happened was, like, you know, this is very harmful for the market's efficiency, and that inefficiency is being shown up over here. So consumers spend days, you know, see this, basically this loss in consumer surplus also has an opportunity cost to it. What is it? The opportunity cost is that the consumers will have to wait in longer lines for a good which has now been introduced in the market, although in lower quantities. So when shortage arises, there would be a set of consumers who are obviously ready to stand in the queues and buy the good in the market, and they rather end up being buying. But there is this set of consumers who either cannot go stand in long queues and maybe chooses to just stay out of it. So there's an opportunity cost also to buying it. So they've written, consumers spent days waiting to buy LPG. This was a good example of price controls making consumers the group whom the policy was presumably intended to protect. Obviously, the government imposed the price controls, keeping in mind that would help the consumers. But it was an inelastic good. So basically a good whose demand was inelastic. So they indeed lost a lot. So that's a good example of practices where the governments think that they're intervening in the market and it would rather help the consumers, but they end up doing bad to them. So that was a good talk, and we are successfully able to understand two concepts. One, when there's a price cap, a price ceiling, in a normal scenario, relatively elastic demand and supply curves, and one where you have a relatively inelastic demand curve. Thank you.